excited to become more responsible and be able to do things independently. Also, I am excited because after my bar mitzvah, I feel like I will be able to make an even closer connection to the Jewish people around me, especially at Temple Sinai. I have been waiting for this day to come for many years, and I'm so glad it's finally here. There have been many challenges in life through these past couple months, but for me, the hardest part was committing to accomplishing my goals. Studying Torah and trying to find my identity as a Jewish adult has not necessarily been hard, but my commitment to these objectives has been. Over the past 9 months, I have committed myself to work extremely diligently to achieve this special goal in my life. During this process of becoming a bar mitzvah, I have learned many things about myself. For example, once I finally make a commitment and set my mind to a task, I realize that I have a much better work ethic than I initially thought I did. From attending my Torah lessons on top of school and sports, I have learned to manage my time wisely and do many hours of work in academics and Torah study. After learning about my Torah portion, I feel that I can make connections to our history, and I have a much better sense of what we as Jews had to go through. My Torah portion is Vayeshev, and today I chanted from the book of Genesis chapter 37, verses 12 through 22. My verses teach us about Joseph and the story of his brothers. Jacob, the father of Joseph, loved him more than all his other sons. After Joseph's siblings realized that their father loved Joseph more than them, his sons began to despise Joseph. His brothers also berated him because Joseph would like to tell them about his dreams. One day, Joseph told his father about a dream. The dream said, "The sun, the moon, and 11 stars, all bowed down to Joseph." Jacob was so distraught by this dream that his son had shared with him. As the story continues, one day, Jacob ordered Joseph to go see his brothers at Shechem, where they were in their pastures. Once reaching Shechem, a random old man walked up to Joseph and asked him, "What are you looking for?" Jacob answered, "I am looking for my brothers. Do you know where they are?" The man said that Joseph went the wrong way and needed to go to Dothan. When the brothers saw Joseph, they plotted to kill him, and after doing so, they planned to throw him in a pit. It is a very dramatic story with lots of. My Torah portion teaches me that I should be more caring to my siblings and should help them rather than be annoying or disrespectful. It is sad to watch the relationship between Joseph and his brothers. Also, I learned from this Torah portion. I should never brag about myself rather be empathetic towards others and their struggles in life. Something that is interesting to me in my Torah portion is that Jacob had a favorite son in Joseph. When I grow up, I want to have kids myself. And I know that I will love all my children equal amount, no matter what. I cannot imagine having a favorite son or daughter, and I start to find myself in this situation when I'm older, I will think of my bar mitzvah. Although there is so much to learn from my Torah portion, there's one lesson that I think of the most. This is that small things in people's everyday lives can change someone forever. Without the man wandering in the desert telling Joseph where to find his brothers, there would not have been any more Torah beyond that. It would have ended the story then and there. Millions of Jews use the Torah today to guide them in their daily lives. This is a lesson that I will keep with me forever. We need to realize that sometimes people that we barely even know can make a huge impact in our lives today. Examples like this in our own lives are following traffic rules so that we don't hurt any other people when driving, or listening closely when people tell stories. For example, we often have speakers that come to school. Most people don't pay much attention to what they said, but if we listen carefully to their words, tiny details can help us change their lives, can change the lives of others for the better. Part of becoming a bar mitzvah is trying to work to make the lives of others better. For my bar mitzvah project, I'm going to volunteer at NYU and participate in the Christopher League. This program has been delayed due to the pandemic. The Christopher League provides children with disabilities the opportunity to play baseball. I chose this project. First of all, baseball is one of my favorite sports and has been for a long time. I love the sport and always have fun playing around with my teammates and friends. Also, as a person, I have always felt an obligation to help others that have obstacles in life, and I like to support them and be there for them. I cannot wait to participate after COVID-19, and I hope that that time comes soon. Okay, and then these
the
are
the things you can
yeah,
say. No, I don't want you to do either.
Yeah.
Oh, wow, really?